everyone, welcome back to my channel. It's been a while since my last video, but I would like to show you a couple of things because many things have changed with Ethereum, and of course the DAG increased a lot, and there are some problems for people who are mining with 4 gigabit GPU cards. But at the beginning I would like to show you the changes I did in my rig and how to improve the airflow between the cards, so I don't have any problems with mining or some cards going to stale mode. So I would like to show you first how my rig used to be. So you can see here I have 6 cards, AMD dual 4 gig with overclocking. So this, I used to have these cards in one wooden chassis, and the 6 fans, as you can see, so the airflow was going the out direction between the cards, so just blowing air, the hot air out between the cards, and all these cards, they were getting power from one power unit, 1600 watts. But I had some issues with 2 cards actually. So 2 cards, they were stopping mining random times, and then I decided to give more space and split it, and so I did the changes, and the new setup looks like this. So I still have the 6 cards, the same 6 cards, Asus 4 gig, but now I extended the chassis, and also I bought another small power unit. So this is about 750 watts, and 2 of the GPU cards are going to the small one, including the risers. The other 4 with the risers are going to the big one, the 1600, and then I put the fans in a kind of different setup. So you can see here these fans are blowing air between the cards, so the hot air goes out, so it keeps the board cold, and the another 2 fans are blowing air directly to the board of the cards. So the one is here, one is here. Since I made these changes, I didn't have any problem, so the rig is mining for about 6 months without any disconnection or any issue with the GPU cards. But of course these cards are 4 gig, so the current DAG profitability, I can show you here the Ethereum, the current DAG file for Ethereum is 3.76, and Ethereum Classic is a little bit higher, so that means probably I can mine for another maybe 2-3 months, or by end of 2020. After that I need to decide what I'm gonna do with the rig, or switch it to another algorithm, Equihash or something else, or maybe disassemble and try to use the proof of stake with Ethereum, as long as you have of course 32 Ethereums, which is quite a lot. At the moment this is the current DAG, 3.76. so a couple of days ago my rig stopped mining, and the problem of course is the DAG file. And at that time I was using Claymore, but the Claymore is not very good if you have 4 gig cards with this DAG file. It's gonna stop at some point. So the only option now, with the people who have 4 gig cards, the only option we have is to switch to another miner for now. So the miner I have chosen is Phoenix. So I can show you here. So this is my rig. So at the moment I'm mining with 180 megahash. So before with Claymore I was mining for about 170. So Phoenix gave me another 10 hash. And also there's a small dev fee, and the fee is about 0.3 or 0.6, so it's kind of the lowest among all the miners. So I can show you first of all the miners which Ethos have. So there are a couple of them, but so Phoenix is here, but the Phoenix miner is not in the list if you don't install it. So you have to install it separately. So the only way to do that is, I'm gonna put the commands in the description, but I'm gonna show you the command for this. It's quite long, so is this one here. So what you need to do is to run this curl command, which is fetching the latest version of the miner manager. Miner manager is kind of a new script for Ethos, where you can install any miner you want by using this miner manager. So by using now curl command and fetching the miner manager, you can request anything you want at the end. You can actually install a miner, you can remove a miner, you can update it, you can downgrade it. So there are a couple of options here. This script is quite useful, and if you want, you can install the script, the miner manager, permanently, and you're just running the miner commands, or you just do it with a curl command like this one, so you don't have to bother to install the miner manager. So by running this command, you're installing Phoenix. So when you finish, when you install Phoenix, then you can type the command cat for the minor versions, and then you're gonna see here the Phoenix miner, which is 5.0 at the moment. Recently they released 5.1, but it's still in alpha version, so it probably will take a while to become the final version. So for now the latest is 5.0. So when you install the Phoenix miner, you need to make some changes on the inside your local file. So the changes you need to make is this. So you have to activate it. You have to use globalminer Phoenix miner. So this command goes in your local file. So you have to remove the Claymore, or you have to remove the other commands which you are using. And also, so let's move that down here. Also you need to add this flag, so to use the dagrestart too. So what is dagrestart? So dagrestart, there are a couple of options. So I'm gonna show you in a minute. So I check out this command. I don't remember at the moment, but I will find the information. Is yeah. So dagrestart is gonna restart the miner when allocating the buffer for a new dag. So what is happening is, if the dag is near the limit, instead of become a stale mode, so you stop mining until you restart it, it's gonna restart the dag automatically. And this is the miner decides this, depending on the, of course, the driver version of your GPU. So you have three options. One is if you put zero, so it's gonna be never. If it's one, always. So always you're gonna restart the DAG, or automatically. So ideally is automatically. So this option also is an advice from the Ethos developers. So So if you use Phoenix Miner and you have a 4 gig GPU card with a current DAG file, you have to use dagrestart too, so you're avoiding having issues with mining. So I add this configuration for, well, since 5 days ago, and I didn't have any problem, but actually I got also 10 hash extra, which is great. It's a very good miner, and this development behind it is also very advanced, so they keep developing, they keep improving it, so you're not gonna see you're not gonna face any issue. If there is any problem, you can report it to the GitHub, and of course someone is gonna reply. So you can see here the output when you type so miner is different than the Claymore. So here you can see the jobs you're getting from the pool, and also the Ethereum share. So I found the share here. You can see the difficulty for the share. So it provides actually a little bit more information on the Claymore, but you're not gonna, of course, you're not gonna able to use the mining for a long time. This is just a kind of middle step until the DAG file becomes probably 3.8, 3.9, then probably it's gonna stop mining. The other thing is, I want to show you from the page here, from Ethos page. Since I changed to Phoenix, so you can see here is about 181. The temperature is also lower. I used to have 65, 70, 75 degrees for most of the cards, and so the temperature dropped a lot. I haven't changed anything related to the fans, the core, or the memory. Everything is same as with as Claymore. So the temperature is a little bit lower, and the watts is a little bit higher. It used to be 832, now it's 852. And of course, because probably I'm getting more hash power with the same cards. So this is the changes you need to make if you want to keep mining with 4 gig cards. Probably after January you have to change to another altcoin, or maybe another algorithm. But let's see what is going to happen. And if you have any comments, put it down in my channel. I try to reply to as many comments as I can, and hopefully we will keep mining for 2021. Thank you for watching. Bye.